shut down several parks until they die off. And 5 Eyewitness News reporter Todd Wilson is live at one of those parks tonight to show us the problem. Todd? Yeah.
Well, Leah, I'm at Island View Park, and we've been here since early this morning. And when we got here, we walked up on this sandbox where the playground is, and there were wasps all over the place. They were flying pretty low. Some we saw were actually digging in the sand, but we had some time on our hands to be able to find a little burrow of where they're coming out of. And this is one right here where a lot of the wasps have been coming out. And they'll either come out ones and twos or a line of them. So this is a good reason to have this park closed and for kids not to be playing here. This summer, Jamie Bachman has a house full of kids. Besides jumping on the trampoline, she takes the kids to Island View Park, which is just behind her house.
We probably go there a couple times a week. We do our daily walk, so that's, we have to do our walk first, and then we get to go to the park and play.
But her daily outings have been put on hold for now. The city of Prior Lake has had to close 4 parks, including Island View, because of a pesky insect problem. Playgrounds are taped off and signs are posted.
They are a sand wasp, and about July 12th is when we first found them in a few of our parks.
The wasps are using the sand as a place to lay their eggs. They burrow into the sand and nest. They're typically active in July and August.
This wasp has a cycle. It's a 7-year cycle. We're in the 7th year this year, and so the wasps are particularly bad this year. What we'll see next year is that the wasps will die off. Whoa!
Bachman says they have a small playground in the backyard, but she says the kids love going to the park. It's like a little adventure.
But we probably won't, with the dogs, we probably won't even go around there now for another couple weeks.
Well, once again, I want to reiterate that you'll see a sign posted at some of the parks, but also you'll see the yellow tape telling you don't come into this park because the wasps are here. Now, the city says that they have decided not to use a chemical treatment on the sand because, well, of course, there's lots of kids that play in this sand. So what they've decided to do is just go ahead, wait them out. They should be gone within next week or two. Back to you.
Todd, I see you're right down there in the sand. Have you been stung today?
Oh, I knew you were going to ask this one. Well, my photographer Joel and I have both been stung. I got it right here in the leg.
Ow.
And he got it right on the inside there. And I'm going to tell you something, that is some painful stuff.
That's why they're keeping the kids out. All right, thanks for your report, Todd. Well, last summer, right around this time, 3 Minneapolis parks closed because of the same thing, those sand wasps. As Todd was mentioning, the city doesn't want to use chemicals since this is a spot where kids play. So instead, they tried some eco-friendly treatments. They involve mint and rosemary. Probably smells nice. Mm-hmm. Sand wasps are considered more of a nuisance than a danger. Experts say that they aren't terribly aggressive. And poor Todd, apparently they're not supposed to sting you, even if you try to approach them.
Yeah, tell Todd that. Well, get ready for a major...